So, Dr. Dennis, my final question for you is, in terms of interview preparation, what's trending these days and how can job seekers be prepared?
Yeah, so what I see happening right now is that there is more meaning making being sought, not just by the job seeker, but by the interviewer. The mm-hmm. interviewer is actually trying to understand more about the interviewee. And this is a little different. Before, it was sort of like check the box and, you know, does this align with what I have on the paper?
Yes.
It's not really the same anymore. Mm-hmm. They're actually looking for compelling stories. So, you know, I've also seen on the interviewee side, more preparation. You know, I've had the benefit of working with folks who lead, you know, international organizations when they go to change jobs. It's a challenge because they've been leaders for a while. But yeah. I've also helped folks who are emerging, you know, MBAers coming out of, say, Columbia, and they're really wonderful MBA program, or the University of Chicago. I did a wonderful conversation with them not too long ago at the Booth School, and helping individuals land and be able to tell their story and integrate the educational experience is really important too. So I guess what I'm saying is that the trend is for storytelling, right? And so if you don't get good at it, somebody next to you in line will get good at it, yeah. and you'll lose the opportunity to do the work that you deserve to do.
Yes.
So if you've done all the work in the domain area that you're, whether it's math or in, you know, communications or fintech analytics, you know, big data or political science or organizational systems, whatever it is that you're doing, please keep in mind that, you know, deliberate practice and having a methodology will allow you to get better at anything in life. Yeah. Whether, you know, you're a kid hitting a baseball at 8 years old or a soccer ball or kicking an American football, whatever it might be, it's really critical to break it down and be able to understand ways to get better. And the only way to do deliberate practice is to have a system and to get feedback and to record yourself.
Yes.
So what's trending is storytelling, which, I mean, my timing's pretty good for kind of coming out loud with this material.
Yeah.
And I'm really glad to see organizations embrace the human side of the enterprise as well. Because for a long time, we were looking at, you know, we looked at storytelling as just relegated for leaders, right? Leaders were the storytellers. But the world is flipped. The world is flipped. Everybody has a story.
Yes.
And so those who have the courage to influence the situation at hand, the interview, with their story, they will actually be able to show their value and worth. And others who don't do that preparation won't. So I'm seeing an increased focus on it now.
And buy your book and practice what you're preaching there.
Yes, I'm trying.
And I will put, as I mentioned before, I will put the link below. Again, Dr. Dennis, thank you for taking the time to ask you these very important questions, which I believe job seekers need to learn, need to practice so that they become memorable. Because as you mentioned, a lot of jobs are being posted there and a lot of people are applying. And to distinguish yourself from others is those memorable stories that you're going to tell to the interviewer.
The storyteller changes the vibe in the room.
Oh, wow.
The non-storyteller doesn't. That's the deal.
That's a great quote. And with that, my interview again comes to an end. And I hope we can meet one day and continue this conversation. And for the audience watching or listening, I am preparing another great guest for you guys next time. So tune in. Bye, everyone.